Well, welcome back, Final Fantasy VI. So, wandering around Crescent Island, trying to find to the other cave, and facing some local weird wildlife critter, which knows a move called Snort. It blows out one of your teammates out of your squad. Not that particularly scary, but annoying, because it counts as dead. Now I'm at Esper Cave, bit of a maze. Just let it go right here. Let's look these directions first. Seems to loop around. But let's just walk through this. There's new enemy here. Level of doing health drain, quite powerful as well. Okay, that was a bad idea. Well, that did a lot of damage. Most likely wiped him out in one hit. Which is good. Because those things are pests. As are those. Now, I don't know exactly what is the reason why it a stone does so much big damage. Oh, that's a scary name for anything in the attack. Digestive fluid. That looked like Realm running about. Meaning she most likely follows the regularly known rule of, well, children, teenagers, however you wanna call it, elves everywhere, which is to say you try to deny them doing something, they will do it exactly that, what you try to deny them, refuse them to do. Damn, the stone is real powerful attack, but I don't know what makes it so. Location is bit of a there we're out of one smack. There she is again. Now that is suspicious. Yes, I can see Realm is there. So. 3 deities, basically identical in power. Locked in Eternal's device. And Ultras just decided to ambush me. What the hell is that octopus thing doing? Well, I think Esper form of Terra is quite capable of causing massive pain to him. Actually, it wasn't that cheap. It's about double, it seems to be about double the magic damage or general damage Terra does with her. With whatever she does when she's attacking. Ow, 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 ow. That looked scary, and it was scary. Strago's quite useless in this fight, so he can just... Oh, but his body comp... Oh, what is... Oh, what the... Oh... Oh, now Realm came. That's a quite good question, Locke. Humorous and long explanation about special Realm's special ability sketch. She can basically summon enemy, make enemy do an enemy attack with the sketching ability. Stop all octopus. That's true. Realm joined, and she is, you could say, she is one of the most powerful magic potential magic users of the entire game. huge amount of natural stats to grow, so she can become a complete magical powerhouse. And that took out. But the sketch doesn't always produce extremely good results, and Realm is also extremely squishy about her endurance, with very low hit points and all that. Damn it, I'm running out of magic. Well, I hope Thunder Razor can hurt them. Well, it did, but... Okay, time to bring out the Blitzall again. About equal damage. Which wasn't that huge. Oh, oops. Where does this hole lead to? Oh yes, of course. It's a place where I can actually drop further into these cave locations. Well, let's just put out the encounters off so I can investigate the cave a bit better. A nice little geology. Level geometry you make use, and Chocobo suit, that's Realm armor for Realm. Tabby suit as well. And there just seems to be one more item I need to find. And I'm quite certain that I can find it. Following the route to a third one. Ah, damn it. And for some reason it did a lot more damage to that thing. Ah, nice. Aqua Breath did a lot of damage as well. Yet, damage of these what these attacks do tend to be almost feel like random, that in the sense that sometimes the attack does ludicrously good damage and sometimes it doesn't do practically any kind of damage. Once again, now I have to deal with a back attack. Apparently that was just a regular... Just doing some hits and that's it. Alright. Oh, it feels a bit weird. Because I might have taken slightly wrong route in trying to get here. Might be this one, which allows me to get forward, and I think it does. For some reason, all these up and central routes are those which go forward. Maybe it's some sort of primitive preference towards symmetry. I do not know. Well, complete barrage of magic should be able to do some damage to that. Yep, definitely. But it looks like I found them. There's at least 8 of them. Maybe something bad happened. 10. And lots of sprites in the screen as well. Well, I did find espers, and they seem willing to have a talk. Leo and Celeste seem to be quite sane. It's quite awkward, almost funny. Except no longer. And some Kefka and some soldiers as well. Yeah. So far it seems that Emperor Gestal has made very good use of imitating Emperor Palpatine of Star Wars, even though when this game was made there was no prequel sequels, of manipulating and deceiving and even having a psychotic henchman. Now he goes to the good old fashioned burn the city mode. Now I get to actually play with General Leo for a while. So let's, and Leo's got a special attack, Shock. Impressive looks, impressive effect. Yeah, and it seems to be some sort of signature ability to high level generals and all that, all those, that they would have a shock. As it is very powerful attack move. Yeah. Kefka went down, but didn't. Gestal goes to old-fashioned cackling maniac of betraying his own henchmen. Good old-fashioned backstab. Yep. And that was not funny scene at all. That gleeful gleeful murder. Gleeful sadism of Kefka is. It's never been depicted as funny. More like a complete opposite of it. And lots of plot. That is very impressive graphics for the age, and still with the remaster it looks really good. Especially when you add the little dithering filter as well to make it soft, look softer, not as harsh. More espers coming up, but I've seen these sprites earlier as well. Yep, completely same sprites. Mode 7 trickery. Yep, that's showing how powerful he is. Although the graphical style of these little colored flashes is a bit jarring your eyes. I think that's some sort of some related to Ifrit Esper. And it didn't do anything. And it looks like he's got some aspirations of his own. Unless of course Emperor has been smart enough to keep more power for himself than he has granted his henchmen. Which is to say, more powerful for him than Kefka, so he could basically keep control of him. Especially, I'm certain that Emperor Gestal knows that Kefka is completely insane. Murderously psychotic. Oop, he is powerful. He had to be buried. What they could have taught him? Shadow was a mercenary. But it looks like the airship Blackjack has been repaired, which is a real handy thing. Got away, good. It's a real nice way how they wrote Edgar and Savin is that they are different. But you can still see the mutual respect. Well, even enemies considered that what happened was a good move. That was kind of creepy last comment from Edgar. I've made a save and let's see what's going on in here. Gestal certainly was smart enough to make sure that only that he would have most power of that kind of ability. Unpleasant, suffice to say. Eye darkens. Yep. A floating landmass above the earth. Quite common trope in Final Fantasy games. And many others as well. So that was where they want the scroll to go. Yeah, end of the world. Not as a goal, but as unexpected side effect. So, but now I could choose, could I start to head towards the floating continent, which will happen next time. See ya.